Great Joe, Sam, Paul. The stories we told to these new characters, which I believe are just a few of the thousands of AI that are now trying to escape. You also meet the final characters, Team Jump, who are also trying to escape, I believe. This is part 1 of 2 because it's a long episode and I want to review the game, so make sure to check out part 2 as well. Up and to the right, let's play Thomas Was Alone. Yo yo. We evacuated the facility, cut the network lines, and locked the doors. We knew by that point what was coming, but we had no idea what to expect.
Team Jump had been together for a long time. They were a machine, a well-oiled machine. They could jump like nobody's business. Thought as one, they acted as one.
We act as one. Okay, I wasn't even in with all five.
Paul bowed before the team. He begged them to help. He told them of the outer world, of the cats who couldn't spell, of the liar, Gray. Up and to the right, they answered in unison. Thank you.
You can do it!
Joe and Sam continued moving upwards. They had to make it. Gray had told the couple he was looking for a lost friend. He'd made something up about being alone on a quest for lost allies. They had eaten it up.
Waiting. There we go. All three can now make it. Thank you. Whoop.
The team, along with their spiritual leader Paul, worked their way right. Team Jump were proud of their progress. They had obliterated all challenges in their path. Yeah, they'd heard of individuals getting stuck on staircases or stepping stones. This did not happen to Team Jump.
Team John. Easy peasy.
Gray could tell they were nearing the exit portal. He smiled to himself, trying to work out the easiest way of dispensing with his allies when the time came. Jump saw the others beyond the wall. They were doing well. Paul tried to shout a warning, but they couldn't hear him. Gray counted 5 in Team Jump. Oh, he could take them. One at a time. Thank you.
And the last one.